Going on, TTC. Well, it's officially Tennessee Hate Week. Well, it's been officially Tennessee Hate Week, but I'm just now getting to do my video. And, BVD. Not one thing that you said in your video about me, that none of it surprised me. It's the same shit that's been said year after year. Talking about the whole retiring thing, bringing up the whole, everybody knows why I'm famous. Then you want to throw up the little pictures and whatever. And, you know, I was expecting something new out of you. But, I mean, with Tennessee fans, I can't expect nothing out of you guys. I mean, you guys know nothing about being competitive anyway. So why should I be surprised? You know, a little bit about the game. You guys are coming to Athens and... The 18-point line, I mean, I'll agree that that's a little much. I think we're going to win by like 8 points. The 18, I'll go ahead and say that is a little ridiculous. I don't see us winning by 18. But you know, your offensive line is pretty bad, and our front seven is pretty damn good. We're going to bring the pressure on Justin Worley like all fucking day. You guys do not have the offensive line to stack up with our front seven. I think anybody that tries to dispute that doesn't know their ass from their elbow. Leonard Floyd, he's going to have his way with you all game. But Lorenzo Carter, Amarlo Herrera, fuck, dude. We even bring Precious from our corner, and Damian Swan can get in the backfield real quick. Like, I mean... Justin Worley's going to be running for his life all fucking game. We're going to force you guys to make a lot of quick throws. And hopefully some of those quick throws will be bad throws, either incompletes or possibly an interception or two. I think that, you know, you guys like to talk about your receivers. But you guys really don't have a receiver that scares me. Okay, you guys... have played Utah State and Arkansas State, okay? And when you guys had to play a good team, you could only put up 10 points. Granted, your defense, you know, played a little better than what a lot of people thought, but your offense still struggled. What's his name by the running back? Jalen Hurd. You know, he's pretty good. I'll give you that, but he's not... I don't think he's ready for prime time yet. We're going to bring the pressure on Worley, and I think that's going to force you guys to run the ball probably more than what you're comfortable doing. And, you know, we're gonna knock his ass slap the fuck out. You know, you want to talk about Justin Worley, you know, being accurate and all this and that. Well, you know what? There's a lot of similarities with that, you know, the same as Hudson Mason. You know, Hudson Mason really hasn't, you know, thrown the ball, you know, downfield. He really hasn't stretched the defense, but the guy is, Hudson Mason's completing over 70% of his passes, 4 touchdowns, and no picks, okay? Here's a stat for you. Georgia has turned the ball over the least amount in the SEC. We actually are the best in the SEC with not turning the ball over as of right now. So, I mean, you guys could sit there and talk about Hudson Mason all you want to, but the fact of the matter is he he protects the football. He doesn't turn the ball over, and when he does have to throw the ball, he's efficient. So, Gurley, you know, he's that's one thing. Gurley did not play last year. This year he's 100% healthy coming into the game. He's going to get his fucking yards. You guys know that. Nick Chubb will be playing. He's not going to have that club on his hand like he had last week. He's going to have like a brace or something, but he's going to be playing. Sonny Michel, of course, you guys saw what he could do last week. So you guys are in for a long day. You're going to give up some points. The thing is, I think we're going to get those couple stops that's going to turn the tide. I think that it'll be a close game for a little while. And then I think our defense, they're going to make the plays to actually go up by a score or two. And then eventually I think we win the game 30-22. So, like I said, I think we win by 8 points, and I think that's a realistic, reasonable score. Everybody, you know, I'll be lying if I said that our secondary doesn't have issues. Of course it does. So, you guys will get some points. But at the end of the day, our offense is, I think, miles ahead of your offense. So, I think that we're going to score more points. And your defensive line, you know, our running game is going to... And see, the thing is, if you guys can't even remotely stop our running game, we're not even going to have to throw the ball a whole lot. So... You guys better pray that you can at least force us into some passing situations, because if not, we're just going to run the ball down your fucking throats and, you know, come out of there with a fifth straight win over you clowns. You know, this is a game where, you know, with it being in Athens, I do fully expect to win this game. Of course, we all, you know, everybody loves to talk about last year, how Tennessee could have pulled it out, you know, but we, yeah, I'll give you that it was a closer game than what people thought it was last year. However, the injuries we sustained, I mean, you guys can say what the fuck you want to, but when you sustain the number of injuries we did, oh, it's gonna make a difference. I mean, don't you motherfuckers get it twisted. You know, if you guys remember, we were up 17-0. Last year before all those injuries started happening. So, you guys damn well know a healthy Georgia team will wax the motherfucking shit out of you. I mean, there's no getting around it. A healthy Georgia team will run you fuckers off the field. So, you know, that could happen, you know, and it wouldn't surprise me if that happened. You know, I mean, I'm not going to sit here and say that's going to happen, but it's quite possible it could happen. You know, the thing that's gonna hurt us, of course, is not having three of our receivers. You know, Justin Scott, Wesley, Malcolm Mitchell, and Jonathan Rumpf—they're not gonna be playing yet again. You know, and but just something we got to deal with. You know, but the thing is, you know, we've got Isaiah McKenzie, who stepped up big time. You know, he's making a name for himself. You know, we've even put Sonny Michel in the slot. And he actually could be a pretty damn good slot receiver, as you guys have seen. You know, of course, Chris Conley and Michael Bennett, great possession guys. You know, they can catch anything thrown their direction. So we've still got weapons out there. So you know, at the end of the day, I expect a pretty good game, a 30-22 victory for the Dogs, and that's pretty much about all I got. You know, by the way. Me and Carter, we have a bet. If Georgia wins, Carter's going to have to buy a Georgia hat or a Georgia shirt, and he's going to have to rep the Dogs when we play Florida, and he's going to have to rep Georgia like he would Tennessee. No pussyfooting around. And if Tennessee wins, I have to buy a Tennessee hat or a Tennessee shirt, and I have to rep Tennessee when they play Florida. And likewise, I have to rep them just like I rep the Dogs. And of course, after that video is made, whoever loses the bet, they are going to mail the shirt or hat to the other person. So, you know, if Tennessee wins, then I'll do my video and then I'll send Carter the Tennessee shirt or hat, you know, whatever. So that's our bet for this game. You know, I think it's my first bet. Of the year, so hopefully my first bet I come out on top. So but yeah, that's about it, guys. Till next time, we'll holler at y'all later. Go Dogs, and Tennessee, you can kiss my fucking ass.